Hi everyone. In the last video, we installed an Arduino library from GitHub to program the different PLC timer functions for the Arduino Nano PLC. We are going to do the same for the PLC counters. Due to the simplicity of the timer library from the last video, I have written a counter library in the same format. The counter options are up counter, down counter, and cyclic counter. You can download the library from here and install it to the Arduino IDE from the sketch menu. For this demonstration, I have connected three push button switches to inputs S1, S2, and S3 and an indicator lamp to output RL1 on the Arduino Nano PLC. An I2C LCD is connected to the I2C port of the PLC. For an Arduino Nano, you can connect three push button switches to pins A0, A1, and A2, and an LED to pin 13. The I2C LCD is connected as shown. Starting with the up counter in Outseal Studio, drag one into the room along with contact S1. Make it C.1 with a preset value of 5. In another room, insert a contact for the counter down bit and arrow.1 coil. In the last room, insert another contact for S.2 and reset for the counter. Then upload the code into the Arduino Nano PLC. Each time switch S1 is pressed, the counter value is incremented until the preset value of 5, which will turn on the lamp arrow 1. Associated with the counter down bit. The up counter can be programmed in the Arduino IDE by first including the counter library at the start of the sketch. Call the class counter and assign to it the object C1 above the setup function. In the loop function, C1 parameters can be set with the class object. C1.cu increases the counter value by 1 when it is true. C1.res resets the counter value to 0. C1.pv sets the counter preset value. C1.cv holds the counter value. And C1.dn is the done bit when pv equals cv. The if-else statement will check the state of switch S1. To increase the counter value through C1.cu. Similarly, switch S2 will reset the counter value. The done bit status is indicated with coil arrow 1. Upload the sketch into the Arduino Nano PLC. Observe that the sketch runs in the Arduino Nano PLC just like the Outseal Studio ladder program. The PLC can be made to display the parameters of the counter on an LCD with the inclusion of the I2C library. Initialization of the LCD and the backlight in the setup function. Let us display the counter presets and counter value on row 0 of the LCD and the done bit status on row 1. The counter parameters are displayed on the LCD when the sketch is uploaded into the Nano PLC. The down counter class object shares every similarity with the up counter, but CTU is changed to CTD and the CUs to CDs. C1.CD decreases the counter value by 1 when it is true. The down counter counts down to 0 from the preset value. The down bit becomes true when the counter value is equal to 0. When C1.res is high, the counter value is reset to the preset value. This can be observed when the sketch is uploaded into the Arduino Nano PLC. The cyclic counter class object is much like the up counter, but with CTY instead of CTU. The functional difference is that its counter value resets to 0. And continues counting from 0 in cycle when the counter value is equal to the preset value. This can be seen when the sketch is uploaded into the Nano PLC. The up-down counter in Outseal Studio is achieved with the combination of the up and down counters with the same C.1. Contact S1 will trigger the counter up, while contact S2 will trigger the counter down. When the logic is uploaded into the Arduino Nano PLC, switch S1 causes the counter value to increase, while switch S2 decreases the counter value. The Arduino sketch also uses the CTU and CTD class objects to achieve the up-down counter. Both counter object presets must be the same. Enabling C1.cu increases the counter value by 1. Enabling C1.cd decreases the counter value by 1. C1.res resets the counter to 0. The similarity between the Outseal and Arduino up-down counters can be seen when the sketch is uploaded into the PLC. Switch S1 increases the counter value and switch S2 decreases it. Switch S3 resets the counter value to 0. That is about it for counters. We will consider the Modbus sleeve in the next video. Please subscribe to this channel if you enjoyed this video. Also like the video and check out previous videos. See you in the next video.